My heavenly home. It's everybody this evening. We do pray for service tonight. Sam is away here. Do pray for the revival in Long Dallas Park. Do remember our revival. It'll be starting the 5th of November through the 10th. Sunday is you Sunday. We already got all the spots covered except for one, and I'll give it out this evening. Everything else should be covered. Little Gary will be here, and Phillips will be here to preach, so we pray for him. We pray for Terry and him as our traveler. And Sunday at 6 o'clock, we need all the youth here. Anybody else that'll help? We're going to start play practice this Sunday. 6 o'clock, so do pray for them. Anything else? Anybody got a word, anything, testimony before we get started? Song? Nobody? Lively bunch this evening. So, all right, any prayer requests before we go to have our altar prayer? Anybody else? Thank you. Anybody got anything before we let Brother Donald come? Is that it? Brother Donald, you come and do what the Lord have you do, brother. We appreciate you.
Some 15 getting saved here, 14 there, 5 here, Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ. To them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior Jesus Christ, grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord, according as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. Let's go to the Lord in prayer tonight. Dear precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we bow before you, Lord, one more time. God, we just thank you, Lord, that we're found in the house of the Lord. God, we know, Lord, those that's come out tonight, Lord, they've worked, they're tired, no doubt. Lord, we've been out in the world doing the things, Lord, that we're left here to do. And some serving the Lord, some's working through the day, some's no doubt going to school, doing different things. And God, sometimes we put priorities in this life and different the wrong, messed up priority. And God, we find ourselves more tired than we should be. But God, I'm glad tonight, Lord, we took time, Lord, to set aside the other things and we come to the house of God. God, I pray tonight, Lord, you touch your people, Lord, you meet the need of each and every one here tonight. God, if we have a care, if we have a burden, Lord, we come to the right place, we can cast them upon you. He said that you care for us. And I'm glad tonight, Lord, we serve a God. Lord, is willing to take all of our burdens, all of our cares, Lord, and take them from us, Lord, that we can walk free. Lord, how good it is to know we can walk free in this life, Lord, knowing we've been born again. Lord, we don't have the bondage anymore. We don't have to deal, Lord, with the sins that used to so easily beset us, Lord, because we've cast them aside. Lord, we walk, Lord, in the fullness of Jesus Christ. We're glad tonight, Lord, we're able to do that. We pray, Lord, tonight each and every heart and mind, Lord, that's here in the house of the Lord, is set upon thee. We pray if anyone has a burden, a trouble, or a care, by before we leave, they'll give it all over to you, Lord, that they might leave the house of the Lord, Lord, a different person when they come in. And Lord, that's what we need to do, Lord. The word of God, Lord, will lift us up. It'll cleanse us up, Lord. It'll, Lord, set us free. And God, we thank you, Lord, for tonight, Lord, as we stand for a moment. God, we pray, Lord Jesus, be lifted up and magnified. Hide us, Lord, for a moment. Lord, let everything be said and done. Lord, magnify the name of Jesus. We love you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for salvation. We thank you for the church. Thank you, Lord, for your people tonight. God, we just ask you, Lord, that your will be done, Lord, in each and every one of our lives. We love you. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Tonight, church, as I thought about Simon Peter and some of the scripture here, thought about it, studied upon it a little bit, and I like Simon Peter quite a bit. Simon Peter, there it says in verse 1, was a servant and apostle of Jesus Christ. And he said to them that obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior Jesus Christ. And I thought about Simon Peter and the life that Simon Peter lived. And he no doubt was no different than a lot of us are. That's what I like about Simon Peter is he wasn't always a good old boy, was he? Simon Peter done a lot of things that was peculiar. You could read about Simon Peter's life and follow him through. And my, he had a temper sometimes. Sometimes he was just a little peculiar. Sometimes the things he said might have been a little bit contrary. And at times you see Simon Peter had a big heart. And he cared for others. And he had a temper. And Simon Peter was a lot like the rest of us. He was living in a world just like you and I in the flesh. And he didn't always do the right thing, but what I like about Simon Peter is you find early on Jesus always called him Simon. Before Peter was Peter, a lot of times he was just a fisherman that was out doing the things that he wanted to do. He'd indulge in the things of the self. A lot of times we'll get carried up in this thing and we'll do things that we want to do. We'll indulge in selfishness and do things that we want to do for self and forget that God's got a job for us to do. We need to be careful. We need to make sure that we're doing what the Lord has to do. But my Simon Peter was a lot like the rest of us. Found himself doing things a little different. But he, a lot like us, like what he said there, he said, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us in the righteousness of God. My word, it's brothers and sisters in Christ that obtained precious faith through God, the righteousness of God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. So that's what Peter had a testimony. I often wonder, Brother Eddie, what Simon Peter's testimony would
the precious faith. It's precious tonight. It's a wonderful thing. Verse 2 says, grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord, according as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness. So Peter's letting us know here that he's given you all things that pertain unto life and godliness. See, he's given us what we need to get through this thing. We ain't got to do it alone. But he's provided the whole package to us tonight. We just need to go get a hold of it. We need to take it in. We need to apply it to our lives. We need to hold on to it like the precious gift that it is. We need to make sure that we study upon it, study upon the Word of God, the things of God, prayerfully seek the Lord's will for our lives, and hold on to it like the precious faith that Simon Peter said it was. We'll grow thereby. We'll grow in the things of God when we do, as Simon Peter said here. But he said, hey, it's been given to us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. So he's called us to glory and virtue. We can talk about a lot of different things. We can get to a church event, and my, everybody will say, hey, we're all sinners saved by grace. Amen. Amen. That's what we are tonight. We're all sinners saved by grace. And you get a lot of amens. You start talking about, hey, none of us perfect tonight. None of us live perfect. None of us is right all the time. Sometimes we fall short of the glory of God. You get a lot of amens there. But we sometimes need to go a step further. Sometimes we need to make sure that we're not taking any excuses, saying, hey, it's okay to fall short. Hey, if you fall short and you feel okay about it, you might want to check up a little bit, because I don't like falling short. I don't like coming short to the glory of God. We do. But it bothers me, brother. It bothers me when I come short to God's glory, because I know he called me for a purpose. He wants us to walk according to the will of God tonight. And he's got some things for us. And I don't believe you can work to get any closer to the Lord, but he knows our hearts. He knows our hearts. do it all over again. I don't know that I'd ever made things right with the Lord. I would never want to go back and do it again. But I look back and I see the road that God has showed me, the road that I was on, and I come down the old path, went through some trials and tribulations, done some things the hard way, but I could find a spot in my life where I come to the old rugged cross and knelt down and asked Jesus Christ to come into my heart. And that's the most important thing we can do in our life. Had to escape the corruption that's in this world through lust. It's out there for us. It's out there for our youngins. Church, we need to pray. Pray one for another. Pray for our kids. These youngins back here get the best thing they'll ever get, because that'll help them down the road. The Word of God is everlasting and everlasting. It's forever settled in heaven. And these kids are getting pushed and put into their heart tonight. And we may not see the seeds of it right now, what's going to happen, but we got some sowed. Something's going to come through in water, and God will give the increase. God will give the increase. Make no mistake about that. He'll deal with these kids and help them in their life. Verse 5. He says, and besides this, giving all diligence. I thought about this, church. I like to cook a little bit. My wife's the dinner cooker. I'm the breakfast cooker. Nobody eats breakfast, and I guess that's why I make it. And that's why they probably don't eat it. And I like to make a breakfast. I thought about the ingredients of this life. You can make some pretty good meals. But mine, if you mess up and you leave some stuff out, it ain't getting very good. You missed what it could have been. Have you ever done that? Have you ever tried to whip up something and you get to the end of it, you throw it in the oven, and you think, man, I think I forgot a thing or two. I run out of this, I run out of that. We'll see how it turns out without it. And sometimes it might work out all right, but it ain't what it could have been. And that's what we're fixing to get into here. There's some things we can do in this life that will help us. We take it all in and all of God's Word, and we apply it all to our life until we fully surrender into Him. It'll be good. It'll be what God wanted to be. It'll be a masterpiece for the Lord. We can look around sometimes and say, I don't know. Hold on, they don't look like much of a masterpiece in your eye. But in the Lord's eyes, if we ever get things just exactly the way He'd have us to be, it's a masterpiece. And He can use you. And he'll be thankful for the life that you'll live for Him. But he goes on and he said, and besides this, giving all diligence, he said, add to your faith virtue. He said, add to your faith virtue tonight. So we find through the Word of God that there has to be a foundation in this thing for a child of God, and it has to start with faith. Faith is the foundation of this thing. Without faith, you'll never be born again. You'll never get things right. We have to have faith in a true and living God tonight. We have to believe that He is who He said He was. That Jesus Christ came, suffered, bled, and died for you and I. Born of the Virgin, there by the Mother Mary. Suffered it all for you and I. Laid down there at the cross, give us life for you and I. And went into the tomb, and 3 days later was resurrected. Victorious over death, hell, and the grave. That's Jesus tonight. That's the fundamental of faith tonight. Believing that Jesus Christ is exactly who He said He was. And that He is what we need in our life to get to heaven. But He said to add to faith tonight virtue. Add to your faith some virtue tonight. So we take the faith that we have for the Lord Jesus Christ and we add a little virtue to it. And you say, what is virtue? Well, it's practically just a good morals in the Word of God. We can try to live good on our own, but you'll make a mess of it, as we've told people many a time. But my, you take a little virtue and a little goodness, the Word of God and the things that the Lord told us to do, and we add that to faith, and my, you'll grow a little bit more when you take faith and add some virtue to it. So he said, when it's all diligence, he said, add virtue to your faith. He said, add that to it. And he goes on, and he says, after you do that, he said, I want you to add some virtue to your faith, and then go on from there and add to your virtue a little knowledge. So we're starting to build this thing up, and we're starting to put it all together. And we'll add a little knowledge to our virtue. And we'll get the Word of God, and we'll begin to study, we'll begin to pray, we'll begin to see God's face. And the Spirit of God will begin to reveal things to you like you never understood before. That's the God that we serve. Amen. He'll help you understand the things of the Lord. Yeah. I'm glad for some good teachers that we have. How we've grown up under some people, Ed Fletcher, my, it's hard to be the Holy Spirit of God. Because when you get the word of the Lord and you begin to study and you begin to seek God's face prayerfully, he'll show you some things. I promise you that. And he said, you can add knowledge to virtue. So he said, take that faith, add some virtue to it, and put you in a little knowledge. And he said, after that knowledge, he said, take your knowledge and add in a little temperance. Add in a little temperance to you. place that you can take them back to, you can continue to lose the battle that you've been in. If you don't have a spot where you can go and say, that is exactly where God met me one night, or one day, or one Sunday morning, and said, hey, you're lost. This is a sin in your life. You need to make things right with me. If you've never been to a place that he's brought you to repentance, then you can take the devil to and say, I come to this altar when I was such and such age, and I made things right with the Lord, and the Spirit of God moved in my life. It's important that we know that. And I said, if you don't know that, fine. You need to find a place. You need to make things right. We got the park last night. God showed me some faces. And that was the one I'd seen in the middle of the night. And I'm glad to say, tonight, she said she slept pretty good last night. Everything was all right. She came to the altar and she got saved. Spirit of God dealt with her and dealt with her. And I told her, I said, you don't have to go to church to be saved. If God's dealing with you, you need to make things right now. See, a lot of times we want to go talk to a preacher. We want to talk to someone else. And a preacher will mess you up. He ain't careful. No, we need to follow God. We need to follow the Spirit to make sure we don't mess someone up in this life. Make your call and election sure with the Lord. I'd hate to be in this life being blind, not being able to see it far off. But my goodness, ever forget he was purged from all sins. Couldn't imagine, Brother John. Couldn't imagine being able to forget what God's brought me from. The devil, he's tricky tonight. He wants to take these things and replace them in your life. Huh? And he won't do it all at once. So the devil just does you just a little bit at a time. Try to drag you back away. Try to get your eyes off the Lord. Get you away from the house of God, the people of God. Take you out of fellowship with the church. Huh? Make you start getting things in your life where you ain't got that temperance anymore and you ain't got patience. And you start looking at other people and you start pointing fingers. Say, my goodness, they ain't no good. I ain't going back there no more. I ain't going to listen to anything they say. And I know how the devil works. And he'll make a mess out of your life if you let him. And that's why Peter, he said, here's a recipe for you tonight. Huh? He gave you a recipe. He said, add these things in your life that God's already provided for you. You just build upon them. Build upon them tonight. Verse 10 says, wherefore the brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For these things, if you do these things, you shall never fall. For so an entrance shall be